The major source of finance for universities has been the student loan schemes. That many of the African countries have this loan financing scheme where government pre-finances students, okay, so that they pay back when they start working. Other options are the issues of parents. Okay, parents seeing it as a responsibility of theirs and then paying school fees for what? The students. But institutionally, it has also been government, where government gives subventions to universities and institutions of learning to run these educational institutions. We can never underscore the importance of scholarship to the educational drive of African countries, especially one like Ghana. So for instance, one gets a good grade at the diploma level, you finance him to get to the first degree, to the master's, until a doctorate, then you retain him as a faculty, and then he what? Imparts knowledge within the institution. In the instance of where government takes students outside to study, it is of a necessity that a lot of them will come back and also what? Impact the economy with the knowledge, skill and knowledge, attitudes that they have gained from the universities abroad. So scholarship schemes have proven to have helped national economies, and Ghana is no exception to this rule.